The following is a presentation of TFNN. Trade What You See with Larry Pesavento. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648 or internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Larry Pesavento.
Hi, folks. Looking good, Billy Ray. Feeling good, Lewis. No, not Larry Pesavento in Trade What You See, but Basil Chapman sitting in for him. And I hope Larry's having a good start to the long weekend. And I know that he was overseas, and I hope everything's going well. I'm going to be here for this hour. And, of course, my usual show is the 11 o'clock Eastern Time, Tiger Technician's Hour. And I have a newsletter here at TFNN, and I will be giving a webinar this coming Thursday. Wow, if ever there was an important time for this, I'll talk about it as we move along. I just wanted to repeat something I'd mentioned yesterday. Dick Gorgens, who was with Hotcom, just a fantastic person and did really good things, and his sister really helped a lot here for us in the den and for Tiger, for the Hotcom itself, who passed away suddenly. And it's going to be missed, and he was a fabulous person, and we appreciate what they've done for us. And I also want to give my best to the family. It's a very sad situation. He was an incredibly brave person, and this is a time of remembering all the good things that he's done. So thank you very much. Let's go straight to the market here. The futures are down. They're actually unchanged. I'm showing the 10-minute chart. You'll see this 10-minute chart has just been chugging around for quite some time in a fairly narrow range between 2082 and 2092. But mostly it's been over the last, since I think it was 10 a.m. Yeah. So for a little while now, it's been mostly between 2088 and 2092.50, 2092.50. This is very interesting. Have a look at this. Here's the 120-minute chart. Look how many times it's tested it right there. Look at that. 120-minute chart makes a peak D in the Chapman wave. You see the MACD, the moving average conversion, starts to go down sharply. Stochastic goes down sharply and then comes back, flattens out above 80%. And look at that 9-period exponential moving average, that black line. Of course, this is not what Larry looks at. These are the technicals that I look at, and I use certain techniques. It's actually a very simple technique. I can look at the naked chart. That is the chart without anything, like I did before. But actually, I did include over the last couple of, about a week or so ago, I just wanted to put these two moving averages in. But mostly it's the chart patterns that we look at. So as it stands right now, we should be in a pretty good holding pattern. And thank you, Fletch in the den. I just see that he said, very sorry to hear the sad news. My condolences to the entire Hotcom family. Yes, thank you. What we will be looking at here is a narrow trading range. Now, Bernanke, what Bernanke says is kind of history, so it's not as important. But we're looking at something very unusual. Just before a major weekend, long weekend, you get late in the day, you get an interview by Yellen. And this is going to be something, I suspect, this is not Fed policy that she'll actually talk about. She'll say her opinion, this and opinion that, and what the Fed's looking at. My suspicion is the market is saying, hey, the Fed is probably going to try to raise rates again, just a small amount, because certainly the numbers that they look at, I suspect, are right there in the ballpark of what they want. Very low inflation, housing market seems to be improving in certain areas, just a bunch of things going on. So as I see it, we're in a trading range until that 130 time frame. Then there's going to be an interview. My suggestion is that we need to look at the chart patterns and say, what is the most likely outcome if, and if, And that's the only way to look at it. Because as it stands right now, let me get rid of this. I want to show you something that really is quite phenomenal. Within the context of markets, going over 6 years in a bull market, a mega bull market, and then consolidating for 1 year, and then coming within 700 points of the all-time high in the Dow, 40 points or so. Yeah, actually, it's even less, 28 points or whatever in the S&P. That is quite remarkable. And that speaks to energy inside. It doesn't matter where it's coming from. It doesn't matter whether it's coming from the Fed. It doesn't matter where it's coming from. The price is the price. I always say price is the arbiter of the trend. You can look at the technicals. You can look at whatever you want. But if the price is moving up, it's moving up. And if the price is moving down, it's moving down. Then you can make other, extrapolate other pieces of information to help you. And also, if you look at the sector rotation, that's very important. So what I'm looking at here is that the high that was made at 2092.50 on the 25th, with a slightly lower high yesterday, made a peak A in the daily chart. And I call it a gray A because it didn't take out the initial starting point in the 2019s that started the latest buy mode to peak D. Let me just say, in the Chapman wave methodology, it's real simple. Let me just take this for example here. All you're looking for is prices come down. Now I'm going to make that a straight line. I'm going to make it a solid line. Solid line. And then within that context, what you're looking for is the lowest, most obvious low bar to start a wave count. And then within that wave count, oh, I can't do it. Let me just do this for the moment. Space to the right, give it a bunch of things, give it 70 just for the moment. And then what we're looking at, I'm just going to show this chart once because it's going to disappear. And you just want to see something as clean as possible that looks like this. A line, you're coming down, 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 down. The price stops, and then all of a sudden, it makes a little V-shaped bottom or U-shaped bottom, whatever it is. It makes a little trough at the bottom. We call them troughs on the way down. It starts a leg up. That leg up continues until it makes a lower high bar. That is the whole bar. In other words, what you want to see is, if you are talking about, okay, now I've got these lines in place, I can just do it much easier. So this becomes peak A. And if you take that peak out by one penny, even if you're looking at something like the New York Stock Exchange at 10,000 and something, if it takes it out by one penny, that is very important. And what that says is, you've started and you move to the upside, and it's called leg B until it makes a peak, and then it's called peak B. And that continues, until you get to, and it does, as long as you don't take out the initial low bar, you are in a buy mode, a buy signal. That buy signal goes to a buy mode usually after a peak B is pierced, but it has to also do with the technicals, the moving average. It has to do with the chart pattern. Sometimes you don't need the technicals at all. You just need the chart pattern. And if that chart pattern looks very positive, then you can say, I'm going from a buy signal to a buy mode. And the implication, this was the beauty of the Chapman wave notations as I formed them back in the mid-1980s, is that it tells you very cleanly and makes it very simple for this beginning process. It gets a little more complicated as you move along. But the beginning process, all you're looking at is, am I making higher peaks and higher troughs? Not always do you have to make the higher troughs, but you definitely want the higher peaks. Have we taken out the initial low bar? And at that point, all you're looking for is leg D. And that is right there. Leg D, and that will become a peak D, and other things can happen. So I've got that out the way, and now we can go back. So there it is. And you can, at D, you can have a sharp pullback. You can recycle. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman sitting in for Larry Pesavento. Be right back. Futures are unch.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed
TAS proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com. Larry takes your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Hi, folks. We're back. Basil Chapman sitting in for Larry Pesavento. My pleasure to be here. Hey, I hope everyone has a fantastic weekend. Remember Memorial Day, just a day of remembrance, and that's really important. Now, let's just go to a couple of things here that I wanted to look at. In terms of chart formations, if I can go right here, I'm going to be discussing this in great detail. What we're looking at here on the left is the S&P index with the Elliott wave analysis. And for those of you who know about Elliott wave, Elliott wave, basically, the core is that there are five waves. One up, two down, three up, four down, five up. And then at five, other things can happen. It's like the Chapman wave going to a peak D, or even in this case, an F, because a five is in Elliott wave, the final. It's in this stage, I'm calling the impact of what's going on right now, especially in the United States, this mega phase, it's actually a giga phase, boats that are 4,600 people going nowhere, they're just basically cruise ships. You've got massive projects being made and construction is going on in major cities around the country. This is a very important phase. And the reason why I call it comparable to the 1920s, it doesn't have to have the 1930s result, but it is comparable in many ways to what happened with the suffragette movement with women. Really, in the 1920s was where women just kind of came out of their shell. The war was finished. They were working in greater numbers than ever before. They were more independent. They were smoking. This is part of the trend, and they were driving cars. That was a revolutionary breakthrough in the United States. We are seeing the same thing in the 2000s, especially in this period. So I'm talking about that comparable pattern. repetition, things change. Last year, when I did a webinar back on the 6th of March, I said that we were very close to some concluding wave three in Elliott wave. We should have a sharp pullback. That'll be wave four. And then only when you take out in the Dow the high that was made, it turned out to be made, 18,351, when that high is taken out, will leg five, wave five in the Elliott wave begin, and the S&P would be above 2134s. And that would be really important in my work, because it would imply that even though you could have a sharp pullback, yet another sharp pullback, you should go to higher highs. And that really fits this whole coda phase that I'm looking at. Sorry, enough with that. And I just wanted to mention, though, that this is what I'll be discussing in great detail on the Thursday, the June the 2nd at 6 o'clock, 6 to 7:30. You can go to the front page or check it out, the consequences of a new market high. This is for subscribers only. Basil Chapman will be hosting a 90-minute live webinar with subscribers to his opening call newsletter on June the 2nd. Sign up now for a 30-day free trial now to access this exclusive event. And let me tell you, I've done this many times. We've been looking for this for a long time. And I've made it real clear that until we get to a new recovery high, we're in four, wave four on Elliott wave. And in the Chapman wave, we're in what's called a retracement failure mode. And that retracement failure mode is an explanation of what it is. It's not saying, oh, this is terrible because you're going to fail. It says that you are under a previous major high, in this case, the May high of the S&P and the Dow. And what's really important about it, it says that until we break to a new recovery high, even though you could call that a double top, that in my work would start to unfold for higher highs. Isn't that interesting? So I'll be discussing that. I'll be discussing what market signs to be looking for that would signal a new high is coming, the implications of international competition for lower interest rates, deflation now, inflation later. And I've been talking about the Japanization of our bond yields for at least 12 years. It's probably way more than that. And the implication being that at some point, the government would be in such a position that they would constantly lower rates, and they would be in competition with other countries. And that I don't see now how the Fed can affect much higher rates around the world with what they're doing. But what really is interesting is that at this particular time, we've had a tremendous divergence between, how can I put it succinctly? We've had a divergence between what happened in Japan to the Nikkei Dow when it made its 39,000 top back on the beginning of 1990, over the December, January long weekend. And what happened after, where Japan just could not reignite the economy. We've not just reignited the economy to a certain extent under very different conditions completely based on the internet, what's happened there. But the other thing that's really important is that within the context of markets, the Dow has gone up fourfold from the, what was it, 5,600s. We've hit 18,000, threefold, and other markets have gone up fourfold. And the Nikkei never did that at all. It just failed. So maybe there is a difference. Maybe the Fed is igniting some kind of inflationary environment. So, all right, this is what it is. And I go through all these different things. Most importantly, we'll be looking at the stocks that should benefit over the coming months. And that's really the issue. It's not just the webinar, it's what we do with it going into and coming out of the webinar, what positions we will take. We've already started one that seems to be working. We'll see today, at the end of the day, whether it's going to be. What's going to happen with commodities? What's going to happen with the dollar? So I'll be discussing those things. So now let's get back to the markets, and let me just show you a couple of things here. The pattern we're looking for, I guess I could do it much better by just going right now. If I have a moment, I do. I'm going to go to my newsletter and just show you something, because I've already marked it up, and that's really what I want to show you. This is why it's so important what's going to happen today. If I can just get to the chart right there. You see these down arrows? What happened at this spike to or just above the down channel over there in, I don't remember, right after the May high, we went down for months, and then we had a big spike, and then it failed. You see the down arrow there? You see what happened in the November? We're also for months in November, and then it took all the way right to there when we could see that was in January. No, more than January. That was in, November going all the way into January, late December, the 29th, I think it was. See that down arrow at B minus? We are on a B right now from the November. So this is where the chart pattern either copies exactly, market gets very nervous, and all of a sudden we start to break the 20-period moving average, that red line. Tuesday is going to be very important, because if we break down 150 or more points going into Tuesday, that says we've replicated this pattern and we should go down a little bit more. No, I don't see this right now, the big extension to the downside. I think it's going to be contained, but it does say we could go down next week. But if there's a spiral up into the 18,000s, we've changed the pattern, I believe. That's going to be very positive. Oh, good timing. We've got a break coming up. When we get back, probably the market will just about open. I'll be back. Basil Chapman sitting in for the one and only Larry Pesavento.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
All Nothing like a Mozart overture to start the day. I once conducted this. And let's go straight to the market. The Dow's up to at 17,831. Coming around the bend is the S&P up $1.16 at 2,091. You've got the comp index, if I can find it right here. The comp index, yep, hidden behind the screen, and it's coming up. And the comp index, which is the NASDAQ 2,000 or more stocks, it is up 2.49 at 49.04. The VIX index is up at 13.55, up 12 cents. That's very interesting. And what we're looking at here is gold. Let's look at gold and gold at this. Oh, I'm a little late, but let's call gold right now down to a 12.18. Gone to a leg E right here with a stochastic at 6.41%. And the MACD says gold might be ready for a little bit of a bounce, but it needs to really break about 1248. It's at 1218 right now. If it can start to close above the 1249 period exponential moving average and that red, very sharp uptrend support line, which is taken out, that's going to be important. If for whatever reason, and I suspect that the gold and the commodity consolidation needs a little more time, there might be a bounce, but my suspicion is that the commodities just need time. They're looking fantastic. The monthly chart is still looking very good in gold. Not quite as much in the complete complex of the commodities, but certainly it has improved tremendously. We'll see what happens. All I can say is that if gold starts to fail by Tuesday and takes out the 12-12 support level, that 11.97 nine-period exponential moving average 200 period moving average, I'm sorry, this orange colored line right here in the daily chart, that's going to be tested. Most importantly, I'm looking at the weekly chart, and that rectangle that I drew some time ago when we were making what I thought was going to be a bounce with a U-shaped pattern to see if it takes out the upside, which it did, that high that was made back on the week of the 11th of March at 12.92. We went just above it. We went to the last high of 1308.30. So about 11 points higher. Now it's pulling back sharply. This is a consolidation pattern. Even if it bounces, I suspect the gold is in a consolidation pattern. But most importantly, the gold stocks themselves, many have held up extremely well. That is important. Let's go to crude oil right now. CL crude oil is, I have a very strong suspicion, and I spoke about it yesterday, that that crude oil is making a leg F and is probably not an alternate wave count, that it is a peak F, and that crude oil should pull back a little more. That would say to me that the commodities are going to pull back, that the dollar should hold up well. We are long in my opening call. We're still long the dollar for a few weeks. And my suspicion is that let me just look at the dollar right now so that I'm not talking out of turn. And as I say, it's just a tad behind. Yeah, this is a strong move from the nine-period exponential moving average. The MACD is good. Stochastic's at 87. The weekly chart, it's just a bounce in the weekly chart. But the monthly chart is the one that made that pattern that I drew and I've spoken about for a long time. See this U-shaped pattern? Two U's making what I call a soft W pattern. Well, that's the same thing that's happening here. And it suggests to me that the dollar, in fact, if the dollar closes the month of May, if it's not impacted by whatever Bernanke or Yellen talk about today, and in fact, if gold doesn't have a sudden spiral to the upside, which it's done before with the stock market just breaking to the upside, if that doesn't happen this afternoon and going into the close, in fact, if we just kind of meandering around a little bit higher, a little bit lower, instead of having a triple digit move up or down, I would not be surprised if the pattern that we're looking at says the market has made enough internal progress to be able, and I'll show that in a moment in other charts, but let me just say that to impact the different indices positively going into the summer, regardless of whether there's a sudden pullback. Just wanted to get that out the way. And that says to me that the market has often gone with the dollar, and that the dollar rallied and then it came down sharply. The market didn't respond there. So I'm really watching the relationship, and I'll give it to you right now, make it as simple as possible. The relationship, here we go, of the VIX index. This is the volatility index based on the New York Stock Exchange, trading at 1350. If at any point between this afternoon and Tuesday into Wednesday, the volatility index, instead of being under 13 as the market rallies sharply, is actually over 1420. The 1443 is the 9-period exponential moving average. If it starts to rally sharply, and by Tuesday or Wednesday of next week, the market has pulled back and the volatility index, the VIX index, trading at 1353, up 10 cents right now. If that volatility index is really sharply higher and going into the 15s, this market is going to consolidate. And you remember the pattern that we were looking at? This is the pattern. It's the same thing. This is the 120-minute chart. Had a peak E in the Chapman wave. It's pulled back. It's in this little digestive phase, and it should continue into 1:30, 2 o'clock when Yellen talks. And this is going to be very important. Let me move it away, because the pattern that we're looking at should say that this second bar after the peak was made in the daily chart should close down sharply if we're going to have any match at all. And if it breaks to the upside, and I would put it, I'll just give you a number because it's really important. If it breaks above 17,934, that was the high of the 10th of May. In other words, another 70 to 80 points higher going into the close. I will have to say that there's, now I can go to the weekly chart, that the Dow, INDU, having held this well and having made this W formation, and not pull back that sharply in the weekly chart, will continue in the W formation with just a little hiatus of about a month or so before it breaks to a new high. And if it starts to fail at any point going into May, Tuesday afternoon, the last day of May, if we take out 17,331, that's going to be a big negative. So the parameters are really clear for me. A 180-point close from yesterday down is a negative shorter term going into next week. And if there's, by Tuesday, if there's a 180-point move to the upside, that's a positive, and we have to expect that there's a real good chance that the 18,351 all-time high is going to be challenged in May. Okay, I thought I'd get that out the way. Now let's go on. So I said crude oil. If I can look at the USO, which had a slightly different pattern, it was a little more mature. It had gone, recycled, it went to a leg D, and now it's a possible peak D in the daily, leg C in the weekly. I don't think it's a short. I think that crude oil is going to hold quite steadily, and it's going to go USO. Let me go back to the crude oil. This is the continuous contract, and that crude oil should trade between the 45s, 3 points down, and about the 51s. And it should be stuck in this range for a little bit. That's my thinking. And shorter term, I think I would not be surprised, because something could happen by this afternoon. If Bernanke, if Yellen says something and gold actually soars to the upside, you will probably see crude oil do that as well. But I'm just thinking that maybe this time is different, only in that we've had an incredible move up in gold and the commodities. This is just a digestive phase. And I'm putting crude oil into that category right now. Basil Chapman sitting in for the one and only Larry Pesavento. I'll be back straight off these messages. The Dow's up 20, S&P's up 3. Let's have a look at the E-minis.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you like it does me, visit everbank.com/TFNN to find out what they can do for you. Again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. Visit them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
It's 2016, and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour, sponsored by Nadex. Up next on TFNN.
Hi, folks, we're back. So what we want to look at right now is looking at the dollar, DXY, which is the dollar index at 95.43, up 26. This is going to be very interesting. Let's see, AB is only B in the 120-minute chart, but let's just move that away right into the corner. Nice. Okay, squeeze a little bit so you can always see it. But most importantly, what is going to be the issue late in the day is if the dollar is going to take out the low that was made yesterday of 94.94 and close below it at peak D. Remember I spoke about the Chapman wave where we look for four higher peaks. Each one gets labeled with an uppercase letter. When it gets to D, that is where other things can happen. It's exactly what you're looking at right now. Other things can happen. The 9-period moving average, that black line, it's just been beautiful support. We're beginning to see, you see that little thin red line? Let me just have a look at the charts. Oh, it's a little tiny. Let me expand that for you. Let me open this up and you'll see what I'm looking at here. This thin red line is a faster moving average right there. And that is saying that it has now moved above the black line. When it's over the black line, you can see it's putting selling pressure. When it's underneath, it's putting buying pressure. Over, selling pressure. Under, buying pressure. And it deflects lower from here, and it keeps going. All of a sudden, over the last 3 days, it's above. And that says right now is the dollar's most vulnerable moment, because if this line is portending some kind of a pullback. It doesn't say major or anything. It just says now it's getting to the point where it's above, and that this is where you often find that there's some tension, some upside pressure. It's resistance. If, in fact, this thin little red line that you can see right there, if it can pull back under the black line by Tuesday or Wednesday, the dollar goes to the magnet now of 95.87, the 200-period exponential moving average. And look at this. It hasn't been there since it broke down back in March. Yep, March the 16th. It broke under that 200-period moving average. And it's making a very interesting kind of an inverted head and shoulders pattern. Could even put, no, I don't get the butterfly yet. What I can do is I can say to you, there is a semblance, just a semblance right now, that you've got a left side, right side price time match that's going to go to from there. What does that mean? It means that we go from let me just put it in here. This is the most, I don't want to be conservative right now. I'm going to be a little unconservative. I'm going to a very important candle. That's what I normally do. If my eye says, hey, you can go to the plumb line of the bottom, but that's just way too long. That would be the plumb line there. If I do that, that extends it all the way out on a daily basis. I mean, it takes it to about the second week of June. I don't want to be that far. I want to be closer. So I'm doing this, and I get a confirmation. Look at that. That takes you to today. And now it means that we're missing, unless there's something spectacular that happens. But what I like to do is I like to go from the left side low bar of importance. In this case, it's this one right here. And I like to draw a line that takes you all the way out. And it's saying that this exactly, that the 200 period exponential moving average of 95.87, and you're at 95.47 right now, so it's 40 cents higher, is going to be very important, because if the dollar goes even close to that, it's liable to move up towards the previous high of importance of 96.40. If in fact it gets repelled, especially today where I've got left side, right side price time match on a conservative basis, otherwise it extends out to about the first week of June, that would actually match this line very well. It says that the dollar is going to break down today and close below its low of today of 95.08. All right? Well, wait a minute. What if I go to the EUR-USD, the currency pair? Well, the currency pair is in a decided down move. The nine-period exponential moving average right now, it's at the price of the euro-dollar currency pair is at 1.11473. It's showing no strength. The MACD is very weak. The stochastic's at 9%. This is the inversion of when I say, oh, the stochastic is very strong. It's in the 90s at 93%. Well, this is the exact opposite. This is at 9%. So take away 9. It's at 91%. If it was a positive and holding, that would be really bullish. But if it's a negative and holding, the books say that under 20% in the stochastic is oversold and over 80% is overbought. I say, oh, man, you've just got that so wrong. Holding over 80% is very bullish. Holding under 20% is very negative. So right now the euro is saying, hey, as far as today is concerned, at this moment, at whatever time it is, 9:47 on a Friday, just before the long weekend, and before Yellen talks, it's looking very poor. Let's look at the USD JPY, and that is the currency, the dollar, Japanese yen, currency pair, and that's acting okay. It's above the 9-period moving average. The MACD is good. Stochastic's at 81%, but it's really showing the sideways move. So unless it's at 109.73 down a tad, unless it takes out for leg D 110.582, this could be stuck for a little while. But what is really impressive is that those very two sharp candle days of the 28th of April going into the 29th. Have been filled very steadily. I like that. That's usually a very good sign. So far, my bias is to say that the dollar-Japanese yen currency pair is acting pretty good. It's not great, but it's acting pretty good. The weekly chart is okay. The monthly chart is terrible. So that's what I'm doing there. And let me just do this. I'd like to go to the USD CAD. I'd like to see what's doing in the Canadian. So the Canadian's gone peak ABC. Should there be a D? Yeah, there could be a D. It's holding well. It looks very much like the dollar right now. ABC. Let me show you an up arrow right there. It's gone to an A, peak A right there. A peak B. It made a peak C 4 days ago. It's consolidating. It's above the 9-period moving average. The MACD is still good. Stochastic has pulled back to 67%, and that's not good. So what happens to the currency pairs this afternoon is going to be really important. What happens to the dollar is going to be absolutely important. And let me just go back here to the dollar GC. You look at the dollar. The dollar is coming back a little bit. It's now down 230. This is a very important moment because if you look at the 120-minute chart, let me make it a little bit bigger so you can see it. You made that peak E, double peak E tops back in early May. Then you've pulled back sharply. The MACD is turning down. Stochastic's turning down. So it'll be news. A news event can spike this thing. And all I can say, I'll just say it again. At 12:18, there is no strength that I can see at this point in gold. But if gold is able to get, it's got to get near that. It really has to take, to start another big move to the upside, gold has to break above 1237. I'll just make it as simple as possible. I don't want to make it complicated, okay? And that's the way I'm looking at it at this particular point. I think gold just needs more time to consolidate. How that fits in with what the Fed's going to say today, I don't think she's going to make it. This is not a statement. This is an interview. So it's all personal opinion, and then she'll throw in a couple of things. I think the trial of the balloons, and she wants to see how things are going to work out. Okay, here's a couple of other things as we're going to the break. I wanted to look at some of the sectors. We'll do that when we get back. Basil Trapper sitting in for Larry Pesavento. Got one more segment to go, and my pleasure to be here. The Dow is up 29, S&P is up 4.5. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. We're back. Basil Chapman sitting for Larry Pesavento. My usual show, which is the Target Technicians Hour, is at 11 o'clock. Just before we wrap up, let me one more time mention my webinar that's coming up. I considered a year ago that webinar to be one of the very important ones, and it was, because it went to the May high and then pulled back in that wave four of Elliott wave. We're close to making a five. I don't know whether it's going to work out or not. We'll see. And what's really important in my work is new highs, new peaks, or lower troughs, and that's simple. So I'll be discussing that with the sectors that I think might be helped. I'm suspecting that we're going to, at some point this summer, we're going to have what I can only call a Trump rally. You've got to have titles for these things, and the media loves titles. So this is what it is. So check it out. It's a week from last night. It's Thursday, June the 2nd at 6 o'clock to 7:30. If you sign up, you don't have to pay. This is a subscriber event, and you can only get to it if you're a subscriber, but you can get a 30-day trial of my newsletter, The Opening Call, and that's worth its weight in talking about. So I just wanted to mention that. Check it out, front page, and this is a great time to do it because over the weekend I'll be sending out charts, and you'll be getting some kind of an update of what's going on. I think this is a very important period for everything: commodities, dollar, the works, and the markets. Let's just get back to the market right now. Let me show you something that's going on. I was asked in the den about the pharmaceuticals and the S&P Select Healthcare Spider Fund. Look how well it's doing this. Who would have thought that the healthcare could hold so well after such a spectacular move going to the late 2015s? At 77.40, a high, plunges to 56.63 on that crazy August day of last year, and now it's trading at 71. Now, this is a very good action, but the weekly chart says, all right, we're in a rectangle formation at 71.05. It's how it handles the 72 resistance that's going to be important. But so far, it looks very good. But wait a minute. Look at Pfizer, PFE. It's on fire. It's up 21 cents at 34.64. Leg E. Oh, here comes the music. End of the show. Sorry about that. I'll be back in an hour.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a two-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your two-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.